This video will cover a few ways that you can keyframe in Houdini. So we have a few objects here, and you'll notice that we have our sphere selected. Hit the K key to set a keyframe, and you'll notice that the translate, rotate, and scale parameters are highlighted in green, indicating that they have been keyed. Now we'll move to frame 240, move the sphere along the X axis, and hit the K key again to keyframe it. Move back to the first frame and scrub through the timeline to see the ball move. Now we're going to set keyframes for the box. Select the box, hit the T key, and then press Shift and T key to key only the translation values. You'll notice that this time, only the translate parameter is highlighted in green. Move to frame 240, and instead of hitting the Shift and T keys again, we're going to turn on Auto key. Move the box forward. And now go back to frame 1 and scrub. You can see that the auto key function keyed our translation value along the x-axis automatically. For our last object, we're going to isolate the keyframe to a specific channel. Use Alt and left mouse button to click on the X channel in the translate parameter. You'll notice that the auto key function keyframed the X translation position only, which means that the auto key works on any channel and parameter that you initially set a keyframe for. Let's move to frame 120 and change the Y position of all three objects. Go back to frame 1 and scrub. You can see that the sphere moves up and down because translate Y was keyed at frame 1 and 240, then with auto key at 120. The box was only keyed in Y at frame 1 and using auto key at 120, so it stays up after being lifted. And there was never a keyframe set for Y on the torus, so lifting it up at 120 lifts it up for the length of its motion. And these are the ways that you can keyframe in Houdini.